Shri Prabhat Kumar, former Cabinet Secretary, Shri Ashwini Lohani Ji, Chairman Railway Board, Agarwal Ji, Member Railway Board, General Managers, other distinguished officers, my colleague, employees of the Indian Railways, all the workmen who may have joined us on the through the video screening or webcast, ladies and gentlemen. Truly, as rightly pointed out by Prabhat Kumar Ji, today is Guru Purnima. It's an absolutely auspicious day to start this wonderful initiative by the Indian Railways. I am quite surprised that it's the first time it's happening in so many years, at least in the railways. I don't know about the other parts of the government. But what better day than Guru Purnima to start this initiative? More so because I think all of us begin our life with the highest standards of ethics, where we are willing to do any and everything without fear or favor. It's the experiences of life, literally from childhood, that shape and mold our personality and our future. I mean, to that extent, the famous dialogue in Shole, "If doodh peele nahi to gabbar aa jayega," is equally unethical. But we have almost, over a period of time, as a society, evolved to start accepting this as a way of life. Ye chalta hai. That has become our credo across departments, across functions. And the reality is that going forward, unless all of us look at change in our homes, in our own self, in our working, as an institution or as an organization, we won't be able to make significant change, significant difference to the way work is done. In fact, the backdrop of today's meeting has a very pleasant decision taken by both houses of parliament only last week, where the Prevention of Corruption Act has finally been amended, something we've been trying to do for 4 years. We did not have a majority in the Rajya Sabha. We could not build a consensus amongst political parties. It did take us some time, but I'm delighted that finally we have the PCA amendments in place in this session and bona fide decisions taken by any of us, and it affects me as much as it affects all of you, will now be protected. And unless there's a malafide, unless there's a intention to cheat, unless there's a concurrent bribery involved or some quid pro quo, we'll be protected from our actions. So it's actually a great day for us to celebrate the fact that now it empowers us even to be more bolder, to be willing to take decisions faster, better, more efficiently, more effectively. And end of the day, it's not going to help any of us if we keep blaming systems. We will have to inculcate that in ourselves, in our working. After all, what is an organization? It's a summation of individuals. It's what I do. If I decide that I'm going to request Chairman Lohani that by kisi tarike se dekh lo ke ye contract isko mil jaye, after that I lose all right to stop Mr. Lohani from choosing two other contracts beneficiaries. And then he loses the right to ask Mr. Gupta to stop some four other beneficiaries from being benefited. And then it becomes all pervasive in the organization. If we have to look at ethics and probity, it will have to be a summation of the ethics and probity standards that we set first for ourselves. No amount of circulars, no amount of Central Vigilance Commission guidelines or even SOPs can make the difference that each one of us can make to both our working and the working of the organization, but more importantly, to how we are perceived by the outside world, whether we are perceived as an honest organization, as an organization which has high levels of standards of probity and integrity, or as an organization where kaam kiya ja sakta hai, manage ho jayega, sambhal lenge. And that's a choice that each one of us has to make. And to my mind, if we look back in history, almost every guru has always taught us in some form or the other good and ethical way of working. I'm not even going into few misplaced cases where somebody may have encouraged a student to cheat in an exam, or the teacher or guru himself may have been corrupt. You'll find such instances. That is our maturity, to be able to pick up the best from our gurus, and if at all there are these aberrations, to be able to decide whether we want to be influenced by these aberrations. But I'm told even a guru like Chanakya, who we all almost believe was Machiavellian in his character and was willing to break all the rules of the game. We are all aware of the Sam, Dam, Dan, Bhed theory. And most business people always thought that is the way this country will always run. Ki koi na koi to weak link niklega, hamara kaam ho hi jayega. But I am told even Chanakya had two lamps in his home. One which was paid by the government, of which he was a member as an advisor to the king. And another lamp which he would use for his own personal use when he was not maybe reading an official paper or an official file, which would mean that I would have had to actually have two electricity connections in my home. So at 3 o'clock in the night, I'll switch into a private connection till about maybe 9 in the morning. But that was the high standard of integrity that Chanakya displayed so many centuries ago. And therefore, to my mind, moral education, I don't know how much of it is a part of curriculum in today's schools, but I remember in my school days, we actually had a lecture, it used to be called period in our school, which was only on moral science. It was a proper lecture, a period where we were only taught moral science. And there was another which also I'm not sure is there these days, not relevant maybe entirely to today's mission, Satyanishtha, but in some sense very closely linked. We had a class on civics. Ab mujhe pata nahi aajkal kitna hai, maybe somebody who has a young child may be able to tell us. I think civics and moral science are both two very essential ingredients if we have to change the standards of our society, or the prepare a generation for tomorrow which changes the image of this country internationally, and of course changes the image of government internally. The fact that in every profession you may find some elements who land up creating a bad name is a reality. So whether it's politicians, it's easier to start with yourself, or it's bureaucrats, government servants, whether it's the media or social groups, civic groups. Maybe every section of society has their bad eggs. But that does not mean that the entire society or an entire class of people needs to be castigated. I'm sure we have the ability to be able to expose such elements, to be able to differentiate between such people and the others. And that is where I would like to appeal to all of you. As the Indian Railway employees, that it's equally a crime to stand and watch a wrong or allow a wrong to happen under our charge as it is to be culpable and be a part of it. Hamari aankh ke samne koi galat kar raha hai aur hum dekhte rehte hain, us pe kuch action nahi lete, awaaz nahi uthate, hamara mitra kyun na ho, hamara colleague kyun na ho, is equally a crime. And I think in criminal law, actually, if you stand and watch a murder being committed, you are culpable. And that, I think, applies to all of us also. When we talk of ethics and we talk of personal standards of integrity, an equal focus will have to be on our commitment to not allow a wrong to be perpetuated in our organization. In fact, I'm delighted that two of my ex-colleagues have spoken today, Anil Swaroop and Balwinder ji. Anil, of course, had a very big role to play in the entire initial days of government when we brought in the coal auctions. I don't know whether he spoke about it at all today. But we were grappling with a humongous problem that the nation had faced, almost an issue which had toppled a government. And nobody wanted to work in the coal ministry. I'd made the cardinal sin or mistake of just suggesting, when somebody asked me ke mantri banaye to tumko kaun sa vibhag dena chahiye, main kaha jo sabse kathin vibhag hai de dena, mujhe nahi malum tha, aur literally it will be followed. But I had an able colleague in Anil Swaroop, and the world has seen how India has been able to actually change the rules of the game when it came to allocation of scarce natural resources and bring about the highest standards. And I promise you, we used to work full nights in drawing up the law, drawing up the rules, regulations, and start to finish from the day the Supreme Court judgment came to the completion of the first round of operating mines was done in 180 days. Takes us more time to finalize a steel tender in the Indian Railways. Just a tender to buy steel. And I recall a conversation I had with the Prime Minister in the context of the coal mine auction, where I was trying to give him the timelines, and I said, this will do in so much time, this will do in so much time. And it came to some issues which were totaling to 90 days. He said, "Yeh 90 din kyun lagenge?" I said, "Bahut humne care liya hai, kisi prakar ka galat kaam nahi ho, ekdam imandari pe focus kiya hai, tight system rakha hai, blah 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 blah." And he just had a little smile on his face, and he said, "Acha, to ye kaam agar 90 din mein karoge, to imandar hoga, aur 30 din mein karoge, to beiman ho jayega." And it was a lesson for me. And many of the colleagues who deal with me more regularly know that I'm always a person in a hurry. It pains me when the kind of deadlines that some of you put up on file to me, it really pains me. That lethargy in the system is equally unethical and criminal. The fact that we do a work in 6 years, what we can do in 2 years, is culpability of the worst kind. A, costs are going to go up. Inconvenience is going to go up. That cost is going to be borne by the people of India. Inefficiencies are going to creep in. More potential for corruption is going to come in. And the worst of all, you're depriving the people who could benefit from that work for an additional 4 years. The opportunity cost of your delay. So it's not only money, it's not only about moolah, it's not only about the paisa. It's equally about time consciousness. it's equally about concern. If we are not going to be concerned about the medical facilities of our 1.3 million employees all across the country, another sore point about which I'm extremely unhappy, Chairman knows that. My second meeting after safety, the second meeting was on healthcare for our 13 lakh employees. And 9 or 10 months later, I'm a disappointed person. I feel I've cheated these 13 lakh employees of giving them better healthcare. For complete lack of interest in our system, we should be considerate and do something for them. That's unethical. एक हमारे एम्प्लॉय के ऊपर कोई बीमारी आती है और उसको अच्छी सुविधा नहीं मिलती है, इक्वली अनएथिकल, इट्स एज बैड एज करप्शन. आई डोंट नो वेदर सत्यनिष्ठा एनकम्पासेस बियॉन्ड करप्शन और बियॉन्ड मॉनेटरी एथिक्स, बट ट्रूली एथिक्स इज अ सब्जेक्ट विच हैज वेरी वाइड डायमेंशन. Ethics is not a subject which you just say, hey, मैंने अपना ईमानदारी से काम किया. क्या काम किया? मैंने कोई डिसीजन ही नहीं लिया 30 साल में. कभी मेरे ऊपर एक केस ही नहीं आया. कभी सीबीसी इंक्वायरी नहीं हुई. शोकॉज ही नहीं हुआ. मैंने कोई निर्णय ही नहीं लिया लाइफ में. मेरे से ज्यादा एथिकल आदमी नहीं है. ये तो नहीं होगा ना. तो वन विल हैव टू And each one will have to define कि मेरी क्षमता क्या है. हर एक की क्षमता भी कोई इक्वल नहीं होती है. हो सकता है कि प्रभात कुमार जी को जितनी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज मिली बोथ इन सर्विस एंड पोस्ट रिटायरमेंट, क्लियरली कुछ क्षमता होगी. ये तो कई मैनेजमेंट थियरीज कहती है कि जिसकी क्षमता होती है उसको एक्स्ट्रा काम दिया जाता है. नॉर्मल मैनेजमेंट फिलोसफी है ये. और जिसको ज्यादा काम दोगे वो ज्यादा आउटपुट भी देता है. बीइंग ओवरबर्डन्ड इज नॉट अ मीनिंग दैट यू विल परफॉर्म लेस. इट मींस यू विल परफॉर्म मोर. तो हमें अपनी क्षमता के हिसाब से, मैं तो समझता हूं हमारे 10,000 जो ऑफिसर्स हैं या 250 जो एचएजी ऑफिसर्स हैं, उसमें आधों ने तो आके बताना चाहिए भाई मैं और काम कर सकता हूं, बताओ मैं और क्या करूं. 250 लोगों ने 10-10 आइटम्स देने चाहिए कि मैं ये 10 आइडियाज दे रहा हूं. 250 × 10 2,500 आइडियाज टेबल पे आएंगे. सबके बीच शेयर होंगे, चर्चा होगी कैसे इस रेलवे को अंतरराष्ट्रीय स्तर का बनाएं, कैसे सुधारें. आफ्टर ऑल ये पंक्चुअलिटी का जो रेलवे बोर्ड ने किया लॉगर्स लगा के, कल के पेपर में मेरी पत्नी ने व्हाट्सएप करके मुझे मैसेज भेजा, सीएजी शोज दैट railways are already running bullet trains in Uttar Pradesh. Sabki bhi news hai sir. Railway to hamari hai. To humne kitna 160 varsh vilamb kar diya isko theek karne mein. Par chalo der aaye durust aaye. Ab aisi koi cheez aur na ho ki kabhi humko sharmindagi na leni pade ki hum aisi sanstha mein kaam karte hain jisne 53 मिनट में 300-200 किलोमीटर ही रेलगाड़ी चला दी और उसकी हेडलाइन बने पेपरों में. ये तो एक एग्जाम्पल है. मुझे विश्वास है ऐसे 500 एग्जाम्पल इसी रूम में बैठे हुए लोग बता देंगे. वैसे मजाक में बताऊं, माय लेट फादर यूज्ड टू टेल मी सम ऑफ द रिचेस्ट पीपल इन इंडिया एंड आई वुड नॉट गेट डाउन टू नेम्स मेड देयर फर्स्ट मनी, the initial capital, by sending truckloads of parts or equipment for the railways into the railway yard, did all the formalities, and then the loaded truck only would come out from the railway yard. And this is a conversation I'm talking some 25-30 years ago. Kabhi sapne mein nahi socha hoga ke aaj idhar baithe main hoonga. तो मैं समझता हूं कि बहुत अच्छा शुरुआत की है. स्लोगन्स के लिए तो बड़े बड़े स्लोगन्स होते हैं कि सर्विस ऑफ मैनकाइंड इज द ग्रेटेस्ट सर्विस. भगवत गीता ने भी ये लिखा है, सेवा परमो something there. Dharma, seva parmo dharma. Lekin it's in our mind. We have to choose. The problem is not of anybody else. It is not even an organizational problem. It's the mindset that we have inculcated, and it's our choice what mindset we are going to leave for our next generation. Agar hum sab samuhik roop se tay kar le ki hum badlav layenge, hum ye cheezon ko naye roop se dekhenge, hum har cheez ko first principles pe jaake review karke naye daur mein jayenge, to mere man mein to 6 mahine bhi bahut hote hain. You can literally change the culture of an organization in 6 months. और मैं तो प्रभात जी से रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा, ये आप देश भर में हमारे बिहाफ पे इसको लेके जाइए. आज जरूर वीडियो कॉन्फ्रेंस पे हैं कि थोड़े लार्जर ऑडियंसेस में इसकी चर्चा हो, उनकी भी बात सुनी जाए, उनकी भी कठिनाइयां. मुझे पता नहीं आज इंटरेक्टिव सेशन को हुआ है कि नहीं हुआ है. जितना ज्यादा इंटरेक्टिव सेशन होगा वो सार्थक रहेगा, उसका लाभ ज्यादा होगा. और एंड ऑफ द डे मेरा मानना है कि एक कल्चर ऑफ एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन डिफाइन होती है उसकी लोगों से, और वो लोग डिफाइन करते हैं कल्चर ऑफ एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. इट्स अ सर्कल, दोनों इंटरलिंक्ड है. कोई वन इज नॉट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द अदर, यू कैन नॉट रियली सेग्रीगेट द टू. People make the organization, organization makes the people. It's two sides of the same coin. And if all of us in this room, to begin with, decide that each one is going to be responsible for the railways as a whole, and if we as a whole, the railways, decide ki hum is organization ka pura charitra badalne ke liye pratibadh hai, तो मेरा मानना है कि एक दिन की वर्कशॉप हो, 5 दिन की हो या 50 दिन की हो, काम तो शुरू हमारे दिल और दिमाग से होने वाला है. और ये 5 दिन की वर्कशॉप से मुझे कोई आपत्ति नहीं है, आप करिए जरूर. पर मेरा तो सुझाव रहेगा कि जैसे अंतर्राष्ट्रीय जो अच्छे प्रोग्राम्स होते हैं उसमें 2 फॉर्मेट्स होते हैं. एक तो है वेरी एक्टिव एंगेजमेंट इन अ डिफाइंड शॉर्ट पीरियड, अनदर इज अ रिपीटेड एंगेजमेंट over 5 or 7 or 10 weeks, where you meet once a week, where you meet 3 times 3 weeks 3 times 2 days. The different formats, I leave that to you and the rest of the colleagues and the department to work out. But to my mind, isko jitna zyada aap kare, aur zaruri nahi hai afsar star pe, har star pe isko leke jaye. Ha nahi, main to kehta hu aaj trackman se zyada जरूरत किसी को नहीं है कि एथिक्स की उसको भी समझ में आए. आज कोई अपोज करे कि मोबाइल फोन मुझे नहीं चाहिए, तो मेरी तो घंटी सीधा दिमाग में बजने लग जाती है कि भाई मोबाइल फोन नहीं चाहिए मतलब कुछ गड़बड़ है. सो टू माय माइंड इट्स अ ग्रेट प्रोग्राम. आपने वॉलंटरली इसको इनिशिएटिव लिया, ये अपने आप में बहुत बड़ी बात है. कई चीजों में रेलवे बोर्ड ने डेलीगेशन करी, कई चीजों में सबको कॉन्फिडेंस दिलाया कि फालतू के विजिलेंस केसेस वगैरह हम नहीं करेंगे. आई थिंक सिग्निफिकेंटली कम भी हुआ है. पर जितना ज्यादा ट्रांसपेरेंसी, जितना ज्यादा पब्लिक डोमेन में हम डेटा ऑनेस्टली डालेंगे, मेरा मानना है उतनी हमारी अकाउंटेबिलिटी बढ़ेगी, जनता हमारे काम को मॉनिटर करेगी, और उससे बेटर मापदंड नहीं हो सकता एक ऑर्गेनाइजेशन की इंटेग्रिटी का कि वो हर एक चीज पब्लिक डोमेन में डाल के अपने आप को शीशा दिखाने के लिए तैयार है. और मेरे अन्य अन्य विभाग में, बिजली में, कोयला में, रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी, मुझे बहुत लाभ मिला इस प्रकार के मोबाइल एप्स के माध्यम से अधिकांश डेटा को पब्लिक डोमेन में डालने का. उल्टे मेरा काम सहूलियत हो गई, मुझे ज्यादा काम ही नहीं करना पड़ता था क्योंकि अपने आप मीडिया मेरा काम कर देती थी. दिन भर बैठ के मेरी कमियां निकालने के चक्कर में लगी रहती, और मैं स्वागत करता था जब कोई कमी निकलती थी, उससे और सुधार होता था। तो मैं समझता हूं उस पर भी मेरी थोड़ी डिसअपॉइंटमेंट है, माफ करिए मैं ये फोरम सही नहीं है, पर मेरी डिसअपॉइंटमेंट है। मैंने कई चीजों के बारे में कल्पना करी थी कि अभी तक हम पब्लिक डोमेन में डालेंगे, मोबाइल एप्स के माध्यम से पर्दाफाश करेंगे छुपे हुए डेटा को, और डेटा इतना कलेक्ट होता है उसका लाभ लेंगे, पर दुर्भाग्य से उसमें भी बहुत पुअर परफॉर्मेंस रही है हमारी। जब भी कोई टेक्नोलॉजी रिलेटेड विषय रखते हैं आप लोगों के सामने, तो ऐसा बड़ा एक प्रोजेक्ट बन के आ जाता है कि मेरे थर्ड टर्म में जो इंप्लीमेंट होने वाला है वो काम आज डिस्कस करना पड़ेगा। मेरे ख्याल से चुस्ती आनी चाहिए हमारी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। फाइनेंशियल ऑनेस्टी बहुत जरूरी है, पर वो अकेले इस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में बदलाव नहीं ला पाए। फाइनेंशियल ऑनेस्टी इंटेग्रिटी के साथ हम कोशिश करें कि काम में भी अपनी इंटेग्रिटी बढ़े, काम करने का ढंग सुधरे, जो प्रधानमंत्री जी कई बार कहते हैं स्पीड, स्किल और स्केल। अगर हम ये तीन अपने मूल मंत्र बना लेते हैं, स्पीड इन डिसीजन मेकिंग, काम का विस्तार ऐसा करें कि स्केल पे काम करें, हर एक चीज के कीमतें भी कम होगी, खर्चा भी कम होगा, काम भी जल्दी होगा, और एक स्किलफुली काम करें। काम तो ऐसे से सभी लोग, सभी एनिमल्स करते हैं, एनिमल का नाम नहीं लूंगा। आजकल क्या है, कुछ बोलो तो छोटी क्लिप निकाल के सिर्फ वो हिस्सा व्हाट्सएप पे घूमने लग जाता है, तो बड़ा डेंजरस हो जाता है वो। पर अलग अलग एनिमल्स काम करते हैं, हमको चूज करना है कि वेदर वी वॉन्ट टू बी एजाइल, वी वॉन्ट टू बी फास्ट, वी वॉन्ट टू रीच अ डेस्टिनेशन बिफोर टाइम, वी वॉन्ट टू अचीव बिग रिजल्ट्स। एंड मेरा तो आप सबसे इतना ही अनुरोध रहेगा अंत में कि अगर ये टीम जो आज मेरे साथ काम कर रही है ये संकल्प ले ले कि हम एक ऐसी लेगेसी छोड़ के जाना चाहते हैं जो वर्षों वर्षों तक, दशकों तक लोग याद रखेंगे कि ये एक रेलवे की व्यवस्था सुधारने का युग गया था, जिस युग में पूरे भारतीय रेल ने एक नए रूप में काम किया, एक नई ऊंचाई तक भारतीय रेल को पहुंचाया। आप सबको बहुत बहुत शुभकामनाएं।
Thank you very much, sir, for the words of encouragement. We will now take the pledge.
Sir, you have this paper? No. It's on the screen. We, the Bharat ke Lok Sevak, सत्य निष्ठा से प्रतिज्ञा करते हैं कि हम अपने कार्यकलापों के प्रत्येक क्षेत्र में ईमानदारी और पारदर्शिता बनाए रखने में रखने के लिए निरंतर प्रयत्नशील रहेंगे। हम ये प्रतिज्ञा भी करते हैं कि हम जीवन के प्रत्येक क्षेत्र से भ्रष्टाचार उन्मूलन करने के लिए निर्बाध रूप से कार्य करेंगे। हम अपने संगठन के विकास और प्रतिष्ठा के प्रति सचेत रहते हुए कार्य करेंगे। हम अपने सामूहिक प्रयासों द्वारा अपने संगठनों को गौरवशाली बनाएंगे तथा अपने देशवासियों को सिद्धांतों पर आधारित सेवा प्रदान करेंगे। हम अपने कर्तव्य का पालन पूर्ण ईमानदारी से करेंगे और भय अथवा पक्षपात के बिना कार्य करेंगे। धन्यवाद।
We just have the national anthem, sir.
जन गण मन अधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड उत्कल बंग विंध हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्छल जलति तरंग तव शुभ नामे जागे तब शुभ आशीष मांगे गाए तब जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे